At this point, we have created a waterfall listing view, which has a block display, and it has a page display. To view the page, click waterfall listing in the main menu. What we are going to do in this video is we are going to make this waterfall listing page dynamic and allow the user to filter the waterfalls by island location or by hike difficulty. So to do that, let's go back and edit this waterfall listing view. I have it open currently in the other tab, but to get to this page, visit Structure, Views, and then locate the waterfall listing view. Notice this time that we have a page display and we have a block display to this one waterfall listing view. Let's edit the view. Now what we are going to do is on the page display, we are going to create two drop-down lists to filter by waterfall location and or filter by hiking difficulty. So to do that, again, make sure that you're on the page display of the view, and we are going to add a new filter criteria. We're going to add two actually. So let's begin with the first one. Click Add on the filter criteria. Let's only update this page display. So for this page display, override, and let's search for location. Select waterfall location field, which appears on the waterfall. Make sure there's a check mark and apply this display. And now we select the vocabulary we want to filter by. So of course, it's going to be location. The selection type offers two choices, an autocomplete, which is the default that allows people to type in what they're searching for, or click on and select the dropdown, which shows a dropdown select list element. So location for the vocabulary and selection type is dropdown. Click apply and continue. Again, this is going to be for this page and it's going to be overridden. The most important thing here is to select this checkbox next to expose this filter to visitors to allow them to change this filter. After you've selected it, you'll see some more options. Filter type to expose, we're going to do a single filter. And the label of this filter, by default, includes the field machine name, which I think is a little bit too cumbersome. So I'm going to delete the field label. For the description, just put something simple like select location. And for the operator, make sure that is one of is selected. That's the default anyway, so just keep it as the default. It says leave blank for all. That means it's going to show North Island and South Island in the drop-down select list. If you want, you could allow multiple selections. The filter identifier, I usually switch. By default, it shows the field machine name, which I think is a little bit cumbersome, especially in the URL. So let's change this to WL for waterfall location shorthand. Keep the default of displaying error messages and keep the rest of the defaults and click apply this display. After you've added this exposed to the end user waterfall location content filter, if you scroll down to the preview, sure enough, you'll see the waterfall location select list. So just for demonstration, let's choose South Island and click apply. And you'll see that it does, in fact, filter. Great. So let's save this view in its current state. So we've saved the page display of the waterfall listing view. If we go back to the waterfall listing page, fantastic. Here is the waterfall location dropdown. Just to test it out, I'll select South Island. Sure enough, there's only two. Now, one thing I would like to do. There's no reset button here. We'll get to that in a moment after we've added the hiking difficulty dropdown. So let's go back to the view. And again, on the page display, let's add another filter. So filter criteria, add. One thing to notice is you see this text here in italics. That means it's overridden for this specific page versus something like header, footer, right? They are not in italics, meaning they apply to all displays of this view. So filter criteria means it's overridden specifically for this page display. If we click on block quick, you'll see that fields and format are in italics, meaning it's overridden for the block display. Let's go back to page display. Thanks for the detour. And now, again, on filter criteria for the page display, click add. And this time we're going to search for hiking difficulty. There we go. Hike difficulty is what we called it. Put a check mark. Apply this display. The vocabulary should be hiking difficulty. Thankfully, I guess by chance, it's the default. And again, the selection type, let's switch to drop down. So that's a select list. Click apply and continue. And again, remember the all important expose this filter to visitors to allow them to change it. Keep the defaults. The label, I am going to take off the machine name. The description, choose your preferred challenge. And the operator is going to be is one of easiest, easy, moderate, more difficult. If we allow multiple selections, that means the user could choose easiest and easy if they wished. The filter identifier, again, this shows up in the URL. I'm going to make it shorthand, so just hike difficulty, HD. And display error messages if needed. Keep all the remaining defaults, apply this display. If I go down to the preview, sure enough, it looks like hike difficulty is available. Let's save this display. Says we have unsaved changes. Let's save it. Now, if we go back to a different tab for the waterfall listings, click the waterfall listing to refresh. And sure enough, hike difficulty is now an option. And if I control click or command click or shift click, I can select multiple ones and I can hit apply. So we're going to show hikes with the easiest or easy difficulty. Hit apply. Dawson Falls, Hookah Falls, Kitakite Falls, Purakau Nui Falls. But notice there's no reset button, which is undesirable from a user experience. So let's go back to the waterfall listing. And this time, make sure you're on the page display and let's open advanced. One of the sections here is exposed form. And the exposed form style is basic. If you click basic, you'll see the different options. Input required or basic. Let's keep it as default, basic. Now let's change the settings. So click on settings next to basic. And here we can change the submit button text from apply, let's say search. That's more friendly. And right underneath that is a checkbox for include reset button. If we choose that, we can also have the option to change the label of the reset button. Let's keep it default as reset. And keep the rest of the defaults and then click apply. If we scroll down to the preview, we'll see, sure enough, here's the reset button. And here's the search text that we switched to. The last step here is we need to save our changes. Click save. Now let's go back to the waterfall listing. Okay, so if we refresh the page, I'll just click on waterfall listing. Scroll down. Sure enough, the button text has changed from apply to search. So let's search for islands in the North Island. Click search. If we do that, we are presented with the reset button. This is brilliant. So reset. And what happens if we choose something that is not available? For example, let's choose South Island and is easiest. And if we search, nothing shows up. Maybe that's desirable. Maybe that's not. But if we want to change, if let's go back to the waterfall listing view. And under no results behavior, let's click add. Again, we only want to change this for the page display. And let's put in a text. So just search for text. and there's a text area here. Click apply this display, and let's see what happens. Let's type in some nice message like, we could find no matches to your query. Please modify and try again. I'm applying to this page only. Apply this and click save. If we go back and let's try again, let's search for something that doesn't exist. South Island, easiest. Click search. And now it says we could find no matches to your query. Please modify and try again. Well done. At this point, you understand the fundamentals of building Drupal views. I hope you understand the power and you realize the potential that you have with site building with views. I'll see you in the next videos.